wrestling is simply awesome stuff.
Welcome to the SlamCast! It's been a crazy night. I am the Sauce. Working solo here tonight. And we are working things off. We are starting things off with a number one contender battle royale for the Panhandle Championship. Somebody's going to earn themselves a shot at the Panhandle Championship. It could be any one of these six men. You have Fonzie LaFleur, medic number two, Dr. Payne, Maui Mike, JD Smitty, and Sama Tamu. But we are live, ladies and gentlemen. Whether you are watching here on Twitch or you are watching later on the Slamcast on YouTube. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for inviting us to your home, however you may watch it. Looks like Maui Mike and Sama Tamu are doing a lot of the dominating here. And JD Smitty also taking advantage of medic. Oh! Maui Mike just squished Dr. Payne. Fonzie LaFleur getting a shot in there. As this match is going crazy on here, I'm trying to keep up with all the action as I can. Like I said, running this all on my own here tonight. Like Maui Mike now going to work on Sama Tamu out in the corner. The big men fighting together. Looks like, oh, JD Smitty, Sama Tamu, and Maui Mike have been eliminated from the match. So we're down to our final three here. Fonzie LaFleur has been eliminated from the match. And what just happened here? What is he doing? He just... Here's your winner, receiving a future shot at the top of Texas Panhandle Championship, Dr. Payne. And Fonzie LaFleur is not happy.
What are you doing?
Teamwork, Fonzie.
I don't like doctors. I I've never trusted doctors. Anytime I go see a doctor, there's something wrong with me. They say I'm too old for this. They say that I'm crazy. They say that I'm not supposed to talk. I had a big milkshake earlier today, and I'm fine. I only farted twice. So you know what, Mr. Doctor, whatever your name is?
I think he just Fonte LaFleur asked for a match. Is this official? Oh, it looks like it's official. We're going to get medic number two taking on Fonzie LaFleur. It's been a while since we've seen Fonzie LaFleur in action. Local wild man. Found him underneath the trailer park over here by Wonderland Park. Making it around the ring. Oh! And the axe handle there. Medic number two now going to work on Fonzie LaFleur. The insane intern. Well, now on the receiving end of a goat kick there by Fonzie LaFleur.
Take off the mask.
Says no. Couple of big shots there. Oh, snapmare nicely done by Fonzie LaFleur. Medic number two now making his way over to the ringside area. Uh-oh. Choking him on that bottom rope. Another big clubbing shot there by the medic. Irish whip. Oh, pop that turnbuckle. Oh, the defibrillator. Meets him in with the splash. Again, later tonight, we're supposed to see a open challenge from JD Smitty, according to our own. Tony Hurst, general manager candidate. Fonzie LaFleur trying to fight out of it here. Gets the leg. These fans are asking for violence. They are very violent people here in the WrestlePlex. Medic number two having a hard time right now. Drop kick. Oh, slides down. Mush eats ring apron. And, of course, that is the hardest part of the ring. Especially on this one, you're getting mainly steel and wood and maybe some carpet there. I don't know.
Seven.
Fonzie LaFleur breaking up that 20 count. Remember, we are. We do have the old school 20 count in effect on the outside. Bonzi LaFleur back in the ring now. Drops him down. Fonzie LaFleur. Only a two count there for Fonzie. Fonzie LaFleur can't believe it. Trading shots here. Fans wanting the medic to give up here. Medic, though, some stiff shots there. You can hear him bouncing off the chest of Fonzie LaFleur. The insane intern. Only a two count. Shot to the back there. And it looks like he's trying to stretch out the neck of medic number two. Going to those tendons of the spine that attaches it from the back to the brain. He's trying to crush him like a melon. Fonzie may have him. Medic may have to stop or he may be squished here. Big shot. Another big shot. Oh, jawbreaker. Is Richard gliding a Fonzie crowd? DDT! Most devastating DDT. And now. Looking for that half Boston crab. Amarillo not known for their crabs. Not unless you're out of a. Never mind. And he's got the rope. Rolls out of it.
Let's go, Fuzzy. Counter, Fuzzy.
Fonzie back up to his feet.
Finish it, Fonzie.
Another drop. Clothesline. Going for the cover. Only a two count there. More Fonzie LaFleur. We got the medic. Medic with an EDT! Only a two count there.
Counter!
Medic going out to the corner. What's he looking for here? Big stinger splash.
Somebody finish him.
Irish whip. No, reversal. Fonzie LeFleur. Big stinger splash of his own. Hung to dry. Oh! Drops him with authority.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, the local wild man himself, Fonzie LeFleur.
The wild man gets his victory here tonight. It may not have been against Dr. Payne, but it was a big victory for sure for Fonzie LeFleur.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, he is a Top of Texas Triple Crown champion. Ladies and gentlemen, from the Texas State Insane Asylum, he is the maniacal Dr. Payne. And his opponent, he is a former Top of Texas Panhandle champion. Ladies and gentlemen, making his return to Top of Texas Wrestling, he is Mr. CCS, the Cajun City Show Off, Dorian Robinson!
All right, here we go. It's been a while since we've seen Dorian Robinson here in Top of Texas. Dorian Robinson has been out collecting gold throughout Georgia and collecting victories, honing his craft over the past year and a half now. It's great to see Mr. CCS back in on Top of Texas ring. And of course, he's facing off against a maniacal Dr. Payne, somebody that he knows very well, as Dorian helped start the training process with Mr. Dr. Payne, helping in the main event wrestling academy as that arm wrenched. Dorian Robinson showing why he is a skilled technician. Dr. Payne though coming back from it, showing he is a Triple Crown champion. Couple big shots there from Dorian. Off the rope. Boom! Drops Dorian with that shoulder tackle.
Quit playing, Dorian! Get up!
Takes off that glove. Tries to trip him up. Up and over! Hip toss!
Come on, Dorian!
And I don't think Dr. Payne only able to kick out there at one. I don't think Dr. Payne was ready for Dorian Robinson here tonight. Big shot there in the midsection. Another big shot. Dr. Payne trying to toss him into the corner there. What is he looking for? Oh! Hits him with a fist. With a face.
Come on, Dorian! Dorian!
Elbow right to the throat, but it doesn't affect Dr. Payne. Dr. Payne, one of the bigger men here in Top of Texas. Oh!
May hit him right upside the eye with that palm strike of his hand. Choking him out in the middle of that on that rope. Dr. Payne. Now on Brett's rope. To the outside we go. Big shot there. Again, want to apologize. There is a little bit of a delay on the camera there. We are working on trying to get that a little bit better. Irish whip. Oh! Tossed him right into... that pole over there. And as you see, Dorian trying to get up now. We are up to 10 here. A reminder, we do have that 20 count in effect.
14! Come on, guys. We need you guys back inside the ring. Let's go. Come on. 14!
Oh, shoulder into. Dorian able to get back into the ring here. And Dr. Payne going to take a break here. He is taking advantage of that entire 20 count. Dorian able to finally get up to his to a vertical stance. Oh, but Dr. Payne right back on top. I don't think Richard can believe he's chanting for Dorian. This is the splash. Two count for Dorian. That flash spin, clothesline. Coffee pin there.
We want the Gator Roll.
Uh-oh. Trying to come back. Jawbreaker. Hooks him. Nice suplex there by Dorian Robinson. Only a two count, says Parker. Oh, they're asking for it. Here we go. Taking him down south with that Gator Roll. Move designed to wear out. Hopefully weaken the neck of the opponent. There's only two. And back in the eye he goes. Dr. Payne. Uh-oh. Beautiful chicken wing suplex.
Dorian.
Two count there. Maybe if we add some herbs and spices to it.
This is your fight, Dorian. Finish it.
Finish it, Dorian. No.
Dorian trying to get up.
Come on.
Oh, Dr. Payne with a stiff shot right to the forehead. And now, what is going on here? Oh! Makes him eat that middle turnbuckle. And you gotta remember, that those are some old school pads. Those have been around since the dinosaur ages. So those heavy turnbuckles underneath are just right there, those steel turnbuckles. There ain't much cushioning underneath. Uh-oh. Are we going to see it? Big boy! Senton! Bowling ball senton by Dorian. One of the best to do it. But it took both men out. Neither men are moving here. Dorian trying to capitalize. Rolls him. Here's the cover. Two. And Dr. Payne, call that 2.99. Still a two count there.
SCP.
Oh, jawbreaker. Whips him over with the snapmare. And big boy crossbody. Two. That was, if that was a 2.99 for the Dr. Payne, then that right there was a 2.99999. That one was a lot closer.
Get up, Dorian.
Neither one of these men able to get it to a vertical stance. Vertical stance. I promise I could talk.
Can I say
something?
You shut up, bro.
You shut up. You shut up.
Dr. Payne telling Rose to shut up and then eats a fifth. Oh, big chop there. Dorian ain't going to be happy about that. Turns one of his own. Couple of forearm shots by each guy. He got him up. Oh, that was a big elbow, if I were to say. Might have rocked him. And he is underneath the rope. Dorian Robinson cannot believe what is going on here.
Come on, Dorian.
That elbow could have literally just knocked the doctor out.
SCP, Dorian.
Come on, Dorian.
Hardcore, Dorian.
Come on, Dorian.
Woo! Thunder! One, two. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Mr. CCS, Dorian Robinson! Dr. Payne, obviously in pain here. Parker may be checking on him. Well, we come back, and well, this is happening.
Step back! Hey, get your ass back out of here. We need help out here. Take out the doctor. Come on, Dorothy.
Well, I'm pissed off.
And what is he? Dr. Payne, we're coming back from our intermission here locally. And what is going on here? I'm sorry, what? That's the Sarge. That's Nathan Briggs! That's the Resistance! And Nathan Briggs standing strong. What is this? We haven't seen this man in almost a year.
I told you the last time I was here that the Resistance was coming back home. We are here. The Resistance is back, and we're not putting up with any more of this garbage that you got going on down here. That there is the main event, Nathan Briggs. He is the number one member of the Resistance. I am the leader. The Resistance is coming home. In light of everything that's going on here, I have no compunction about spending some money that I have. We're coming back here next week. Dr. Payne and his little crew of medics are in for some trouble. The Resistance is coming from them. I challenge Dr. Payne right now to a match with the Resistance and his tag team partners right here. Right here at the WrestlePlex in top of Texas. The Resistance is home, and we're going to kick some tail feathers. Take it to the bank.
Oh, wow. That is... That is... I don't know if you guys heard that. Oh man, I gotta take a break.
There you go, doggo. You don't even have to redeem or anything.
Oh god!
No! Hey, that killed me.
Yeah, that killed me too.
This is going to fall, okay? You don't have to do that.
I mean,
what? But still.
glorious reception that you top of Texas fans should be having here, man. Feel welcome.
Get out of here.
I'm okay.
What
you
doing? Well, he's calling himself, isn't he?
Of course.
Put your necks to, and it's
manager.
If he knows so much, why did they have to vote for him? Why wasn't he given this job?
Because there's two other candidates.
Two other candidates?
There's two other candidates.
This election now?
Yeah.
Why don't you shut up? You shut up! Every single one of you shut up!
Well, he definitely doesn't meet the standards of the resistance. There's no doubt about that. I've already counted him off on three of the pillars, and he has no business being in the ring, if you ask me.
This man puts the ones that deserve where they need to be. Right there, look at it. Look at it. Listen to
you
the
want a general manager that walks around with a sledgehammer?
Everything to Tony Hawk.
Really?
So every single one of you, you're going to do your job. You're going to vote Tony Hawk for CEO. You shut it off already! Nobody! Tony's not even here tonight! Tony Hurst is here for you!
Are they going to talk all night? I thought he was defending his title tonight. Is that what's going on?
I'm not sure. He was supposed to be having an open challenge, but yeah.
Is that what he does? Is open challenges? You realize that you do that to resistance, you're going to lose your gold.
Well, he's got a number one contender online, but the gentleman isn't here tonight.
You shut it up! Nobody loves Scotty! 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 Oh, he's not here for you! You got to deal with me! Let me tell you something.
I see an awful lot of yelling, an awful lot of talking, but I don't see no wrestling going on.
After my little inconvenience last week, thank you, APA.
Yeah, he just did get out of
another thing. If it wasn't for Tony Hurst,
you get that hat out of a dumpster.
Out on some injustification, I wouldn't be here tonight. Hurst made Bill! Hurst made Bill! Thank you! Because otherwise you wouldn't see me this week! And we all know you came here to see me!
Oh, that's what two people at least think.
You know what? Since I left last week, and just so happens the new number one contender isn't here, I'm gonna give y'all a treat. Ready? I'm gonna do something for each and every one of you.
So you overheard him in the
you shut it up!
What he was gonna do, because he knew the guy wasn't
here. Oh yeah.
That's what would be a surprise.
That's what happens when you live in the internet.
Why don't you do your job, Parker?
Here's what's gonna happen.
He is doing his job. He's standing in the ring waiting for whoever he's going to call out, obviously.
Senior heavyweight title on the line today. Because I don't give a damn about a number one contender.
Oh, you don't have to.
Ain't nobody taking
it from
me. He's
got the title. He can wrestle if he wants to. If he loses the belt,
so here's what's going to happen.
It's true.
I'm going to lay it out right here. Right there. There it is. Y'all see that? Put your damn glasses on so you can see it. Parker, you see it?
I can clearly
see it. Parker sees it.
You should.
There you go. Tell him. Make your announcement.
So to anyone, shut it up. I'm still talking here. Are you understanding me? Every single one of you, shut it up. Back locker room that thinks they got what it takes to take on the blue collar brawler and strip me of my beloved junior heavyweight title, you bring it on, cause I'm gonna whiskey lullaby you and put you right to sleep.
You can't
So who's going to answer the challenge?
Well, that's what I'm curious about. Who's going to stand up to this individual? He's an exact.
Oh boy.
I don't think he's. You know what? I'm thinking he might be a couple of sandwiches short of a picnic.
Uh-oh. Something's coming.
Oh, it's nice and dark in here.
What is going on, partner? What is it?
Why does he keep asking the referee what's going on? He's there to the rest of the match. You don't know what's going on anymore than anybody else.
He's going to be your general manager.
I still haven't shipped my job. Oh! I recognize this young man.
Okay, what do we got here? I haven't been over here in a while. What's going on there, Mr. Man?
This man has made his, technically his return last week. Mr. Curtis Dawn. And he is, well, let's just say if he had some sparkles and it was night to, daytime, Edward would be calling right about now.
And that is who?
That's a Twilight reference.
Oh, it's one of the millennial things that I could care less about.
Yes.
Okay, just checking. I don't like the idea of this man walking around with a sledgehammer in his hand.
Oh, hi, Tony.
What is
it? Introducing the man who answered the JD Smitty Open Challenge. He hails from the dark shadows of Salem, Massachusetts. Ladies and gentlemen, he is Curtis Dawn.
Cheese done slid off his cracker.
A little bit.
They were booing his opponent, and he gets mad at his at the fans. I'm like, what is that?
Come on, JD. I need you inside the ring.
As JD Smitty, not sure if he wants to face off against Curtis Dawn here. So, for those of you who are joining us on the Slamcast right now, I am joined here by the leader of the resistance, who we just saw just a few moments ago, the sergeant over here, and you guys are issuing an open challenge to Dr. Payne and Medic?
Any and all of Dr. Payne's crew and their little stretcher bearers and their siren wailing individuals. The resistance don't like them, so we're going to take care of them, i.e. we're going to take them out.
I mean, it wouldn't be the first time that the resistance and the medics have, you know, clashed before.
No, we've dealt with them before, and we'll take care of them just as easily now as we did in the past.
But apparently next Saturday night, the resistance returns home. Apparently it's going to be Nathan Brown. Are you going to spoil us, or are we going to have to wait until next week?
Have I ever spoiled anything?
You're
have
right.
When I told you something was going to happen, has it not ever happened?
Rocky! This is true. What?
What is that?
That's, I don't know. I'm trying to figure out what you
Curtis
are.
That's Curtis Dawn.
Ask him any questions. Does he not know who he's talking to? Obviously not.
Champion!
may need some garlic on that belt afterwards. If he doesn't win it here tonight.
He definitely wants to keep his belt. He keeps taking it away from the referee. Like he doesn't really want to put it up.
I mean, we've only seen Curtis Don in action one time. And that was last week.
Okay.
And
I wasn't here, of course.
Yeah, no. Scotty Tucker wasn't a fan of Curtis Don. Something about vampires, apparently.
Who wasn't a fan?
My regular guy.
I do not know this individual.
No, you do not.
And why is he not here?
He's one of the other candidates for general managership. He's out doing some campaigns.
Wait a minute. They're going to make an announcer color commentary person a general manager?
I'm
going to
break fourth wall here. I was the general manager for a year and a half.
Yes, you're not one now, and there's a reason for that, but we'll continue.
Yeah, that's because Jack... anyways. Go back behind my fourth wall, Dan.
We don't need the Godfather.
Bring the nose!
There you go. Look at that. Cute little thing. Anyway.
So I go back behind my fourth wall now, sir.
Not a problem.
Now I know how it feels. I'm going to apologize to Scott next week.
Well, that's what you youngsters do. You apologize for everything because you're afraid you're going to hurt somebody's feelings. You realize I don't care about your feelings or anybody else's. All I care about is getting the resistance more bookings, getting the resisting more championship belts, and putting these individuals out of the way because they don't match the pillars, the four pillars that are the foundation of the resistance.
I do remember the resistance being very much against gimmicks like what we're seeing in the ring tonight.
Professionalism. That's one of the biggest pillars of the resistance. Proper training and equipment is another pillar. Education always factors in. That falls under the training aspect. But he's hiding behind his manager. What is wrong with him? I thought he was a champion. He needs to get in there and defend his title.
I think he is afraid of Curtis Stone.
He's going to run away.
He is literally leaving the building right now. He is left.
How many times has he done that? You don't really have an authority figure here to make these people follow the guidelines and the rules and regulations of professional wrestling.
Well, we've got a Parker and we've got a Jack Logan.
Oh.
Mario!
Well, we need to fix that.
I tried. But he wouldn't fire me until he was able to fire me.
Gonna have to grow up.
JD Smitty is. JD Smitty taking advantage of this old school 20 count. Are we finally gonna see him walk up?
I just don't understand what he's doing.
Which
is
one?
He attempting to do something psychological?
Which
or is
one?
He just showing how unskilled, unprofessional, and cowardly that he is.
I don't know about that. I mean, JD Smitty is a Grand Slam champion. He's held the tag team titles, one of the last.
Well, who did he pay off?
He teamed with Nolan Phillips, and he was one.
Well, who did his manager pay off? One of the two didn't pay off.
I didn't pay off anybody.
Did you accept the payoff?
Nope.
Just curious. He's attempting to play some kind of psychological game, some delaying game here. But obviously his opponent is not falling for it. And he's obviously got some kind of a bluff over it, old cue ball there.
Finally,
well,
collar
we finally
and elbow.
Have a collar and elbow tie up.
Come around. Oh, one to the back.
JD Smitty, is that what you're
doing? Oh! What? Big lariat. And it just does not affect. I think.
Okay.
Go for that matrix dodge there. Well, their head scissors almost took himself out there on the leg of Parker.
Well, he obviously is not worried about the damage to his own body. But well, once again, Curtis Smitty is out of the ring. Once again, his manager is going to coddle him. This is interesting.
Look, I got nothing to say about it. Again, I was able to take the man to the heavyweight title, and when he was a heavyweight champion, he was a fighting champion. I don't know what it is with the junior heavyweight title.
Maybe I'm lucky I wasn't around. Of course, I was out garnering the success of the resistance that they now have.
Oh! Oh, no! Oh!
Now, there was a nice leap over the top rope on
that
the ground.
Was... Somebody landed wrong on that.
If you're that scared, get away from the ring.
Oh!
Well, there's
back into the most. And again, want to apologize about this camera. A little bit of a leg is
well. It appears he might have some skill.
Leg drop
on the apron outside the ring. Throw this match out, he's going to retain his belt and he's not even wrestling. He's just beating the living daylights out of this kid.
And they just do what he needs to do here. JD Smitty. Going around his leg.
Nice leg drop. Locking him up.
The two count now. Looking for almost like the Indian lock there. Doesn't have all of it though. Does have his hair though. Now Curtis Dawn with some big shots there. Oh, he's looking for the neck.
I thought he was a fighting champion. Why does he keep leaving the ring? Taking a moment to collect himself in the ring.
I don't need to do it. I don't have to do it right here.
No. I thought you were a fighting champion. Get back in the ring.
Well, there goes. Well, would that be Curly or Mo?
That's a good one.
It's been a while since I've watched some Stooges. He's got him hooked.
Yeah, suplex, getting him up for
trying
a
to.
Over the, and oh! Turns it into a power slam. Reversed it, but the referee reversed that again. Reversed it, oh, kicked out again. You know, he could have reversed that into totally reversed the hole.
Oh, now he's going. Now he's going for the death of Curtis Dawn.
He just asked for a timeout.
Look, he's been arguing with Parker about this book since he got to be a special guest referee a couple of weeks back.
There's no such thing as timeout in wrestling.
You and me both know this. We trained Parker. He knows this. Curtis up. Jawbreaker. Oh, nice dropkick there. Able to get a last minute.
Must have some type of resilience because he keeps coming back. He keeps kicking out, but he's not making any headway.
Couple of shots here from Curtis Dawn, getting him into the corner. Climbing up the rope. Oh, DDT. Using Brett's rope as leverage. Two count. He's going for the neck. Curtis Dawn, I don't think he's appreciative that
I don't
of the
even
fact
think he's trying to wrestle. I'm thinking he's just trying to kiss that man's neck.
Kiss, yes. That's what he's going for. It's a big smooch on the neck. He's definitely not looking for a midnight snack.
Did anybody put a crucifix in this kid's face? I'm just asking. You know, I'm just wondering to see if that would work.
Uh-oh. Oh, elbow drop. Might not have got all of it, though.
Okay.
Parker right on top of it. Go for the Irish whip.
Oh my goodness.
Oh!
That was
a spine buster and a half.
You do realize, though, that if Nathan Briggs was to give JD Smitty a spine buster, he wouldn't get up.
That would be over. Speaking of getting up, big man, get. Trying to put him to sleep.
He's got some resilience and some stamina. He's not giving in. High threshold of pain, obviously.
Squeezing the melon. And he's got a handful of hair there as well.
Walking away or getting disqualified, I see. That's what it appears like to me. That's what his whole plan is, to just beat on somebody and walk away.
Oh, God! I think he just spit something in the eye of JD Smitty. May have been some sort of mist or something. Sling blade there.
That's a variation on a sling blade. Now what do we got going here?
Is he looking for? Oh, almost a cross body there. Curtis is calling for the end here. Neck breaker, oh!
instead of.
Yeah, he's not capitalizing. Okay, here we go.
You're not going to get a championship if you don't go for the pin every chance you get.
He got his foot on the rope there at the very last second.
Oh, the positioning. He's got foot and hand out.
He's going up top. What is he thinking? Missed whatever that was. Hooks him. Whiskey! Lullaby! Here is your winner, and still, top of Texas, Junior Heavyweight Champion, the Blue Collar Brawler, J.D. Smitty! Try to get that gunk out of his eye.
You should have caught that! Use your glasses! Give us that!
Smitty,
what's he doing?
Got Barbara Dunkelman or whatever that,
doing that,
whatever that sledgehammer's name is. The following contest is scheduled for one fall, with bandwidth remaining. Introducing first, he hails from the Isle of Maui. He weighs in at a quarter ton of tropical fun. Ladies and gentlemen, making his top of Texas debut, Maui Mai! From the Pawnee Giants, weighing in tonight at well over 300 pounds, he is the Barbarian.
No, no,
Solo Tomu! So here we go. It is big boy season once again in the WrestlePlex. And Sama Tamu already starting off strong. Still thinking about 2 weeks ago when he had that beer bottle clocked upside his head. Now we make making his debut here. May not have chosen the best person to face off in his top of Texas debut in Sama Tamu. He's been making a scene of himself in the Oklahoma area. Close line there by Sama Tamu again. Sama Tamu's got to be thinking about 2 weeks ago, when Jack Logan took that beer bottle and smashed it across his head. Big Man Blade with the blood bath there at the end. Sama Tamu was trying to regain that top of Texas heavyweight championship. And you know there's got to be another match between those two down the line. Oh, big chop there. Oh, that one had some sting to it. Double overhand chop. Oh, and a knife edge chop.
Like, hey, get him out of the corner.
one count. Big clubbing forearm there by Sama Tamu. Oh, drop. Because Damien is going to be over here. If he has some insight, he can always chime in. Only a two count there. Another two count. Now Sama Tamu. Is he going up top? Is he going to Brett's rope? Goes with a big splash. Oh! May have overshot it just a little bit. Big boys trading blows. Maui Mike has him on the rope. Trying to get him up and over. Oh!
Oh, shit.
Damien, I don't know if you felt that, but I felt that in the ground.
I felt the pole. I felt those chops earlier.
I meant when he fell right there and it shook the ground.
What did I walk into?
Big boy season.
I thought it was a boxing match.
Sama down. Sama has not been able to get up since being clotheslined over that top rope.
Did his head hit that pole?
I think it may have clunked there at the end. Richard, of course, trying to make himself sound bigger and better. Oh, God.
No.
Don't do this. Sama Tamu is up. Maui Mike has it in his crosshairs. Oh, thank God. Oh. Clothesline. And puts him into the post there. Now back in the ring. I agree with that, lady.
Too late, I think Mom was already mad.
Oh yeah, definitely. Now he might, look at the arm. Oh, nice neck breaker there. Now the man from Maui. You're dragging him to the middle of the ring. He goes up to Brett's rope. Oh!
Oh!
Damien, we may have to check those boards after the show here tonight.
I'll order more. Holy cow.
Because not only did they bounce, that ring jumped.
Oh, not again.
Looking for the ball, no bomb!
One, two, three, bring
the bell! And that is it! Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Sama Tamu, the Barbarian! Big victory there for Sama Tamu. And you know Big and Bad Blade's got to be watching this.
He better be.
He better. Sama took Maui Mike to the limit. And as you can see, Maui Mike's still trying to get better. We're going to call that to a close.